And so let us stand and sing our gathering song together, found on page 20, Change Our Hearts.
Good morning to you. Welcome to the first Sunday of Lent. We are off to a good start after Wednesday. We are 10% through. But it's a long road that we journey on together. And we increase the light that it may motivate us to be a better people. Let us begin with the cross. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And may grace and peace of God, Creator, may love for our Savior and the Holy Spirit that drives us be with you.
And with your spirit.
Pausing as we begin, aware of what we have yet to do.
Lord Jesus, by water and spirit, you give us new life. Christ Jesus, by the cross, you bring pardon and hope. Lord Jesus, by your death, you brought peace to the sinner.
Thank you.
Almighty God, have mercy, forgive, and bring this people to your life forever. Oh, what are you sitting down for? You're supposed to stand for me. We're back. Grant to these, Almighty One, who stand, yearly observance of the holy period, to grow in their understanding of what has been hidden by Christ, to be by worthy conduct pursuing the effects of grace. We ask this in Jesus. You live and reign with the Spirit. You are one forever and ever. Amen. Now you may be seated. And now I would call forth the young people. I can see you. The others are sitting. There you are. Here you are. You're more numerous than I thought. Nice red hair. Go, children of God, and learn the ways of Jesus.
Today's reading from the book of Genesis takes place after the story of Noah and the great flood. Israelite people of long ago saw the rainbow as a symbol of a warrior god hanging up his hunting bow as a peaceful gesture. The rainbow symbolizes the solemn promise that God makes to Noah.
A proclamation from the book of Genesis. God said to Noah and to his sons with him, "As for me, I am establishing my covenant with you and your descendants after you, and with every living creature that is with you, the birds, the domestic animals, and every animal on the earth with you, as many as came out of the ark. I establish my covenant with you, that never again shall all flesh be cut off by the waters of a flood, and never again shall there be a flood to destroy the earth." God said, "This is the sign of the covenant that I make between me and you and every living creature that is with you, for all future generations. I have set my bow in the clouds, and it shall be a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. When I bring clouds over the earth, and the bow is seen in the clouds, I will remember my covenant that is between me and you and every living creature of all flesh. And the waters shall never again become a flood to destroy all flesh." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Amen.
Our second reading today reminds us that just as Noah was saved through the ark, we are saved through baptism. Early Christians believed that those who died before the coming of Jesus awaited redemption in a shadowy existence described here as a prison. When we say in the Apostles' Creed that Jesus descended into hell, we are saying that Jesus went to announce to those waiting in that prison that they had been saved.
A proclamation from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, Christ suffered for sins once for all, the righteous for the unrighteous, in order to bring you to God. He was put to death in the flesh, but made alive in the spirit, in that he also went to preach to the spirits in prison. In former times, they did not obey when God waited patiently in the days of Noah, during the building of the ark, in which a few, that is, eight persons, were saved through water. Baptism, which this prefigured, now saves you. Not as a removal of dirt from the body, but as an appeal to God for a good conscience through the resurrection of Jesus Christ. He has gone into heaven and is at the right hand of God, with angels, authorities, and powers made subject to him. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. The Spirit drove Jesus out into the desert, and he remained there for 40 days, tempted by Satan. He was among wild beasts, but the angels ministered to him. Then, after John had been arrested, Jesus came to Galilee, proclaiming the good news of the gospel, And he said this, "This is the time of fulfillment. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the good news." The Gospel of the Lord. On Ash Wednesday and the first Sunday of Lent, it's particularly valuable to rise above the individual days to look at the season and to be aware that every Lent, last, this, next, there should be a journey. We should end up spiritually in a different place on Easter Sunday than we were on Ash Wednesday or are today. So let's look first at Jesus' journey this Lent, cycle B, the Gospel of Mark. All of the Gospels, all of the cycles begin, the Synoptic Gospels, all begin with the same two first Sundays of Lent. We begin with Jesus in the desert. We begin looking at him being away for 40 days to prepare for his journey to Jerusalem. Jesus then goes to the mountaintop and is transfigured before his apostles. He becomes the light. But he and they have to come down off of that mountaintop. They need to go into the world. The journey continues, and interestingly then, the very first thing Jesus encounters this year in the Gospel of Mark are the merchants in the temple. Put another way, he comes back to the reality of society in his time and the challenges that he needs to bring to have people understand that their actions may not be the right actions to follow God. The fourth Sunday of Lent, Jesus does what he did so often. It is his identity in his ministry. He reaches out and touches the deaf man and restores his hearing. He goes to those who are hurting, the outcast and the marginalized. The next Sunday, Jesus tells his disciples what he must go through. He tells them about the kind of death he was going to endure, but his journey will continue anyway. The next Sunday, we live the Passion, Palm Sunday. We re-enter that journey. But on the seventh Sunday, outside of Lent, we enter the glory and the light and the life that is to come every year anew in Easter. Okay, so here we are. It's the first Sunday of Lent for us. We too are being called by God to go away for 40 days, to separate ourselves from the world. As we begin, I couldn't help but think not what would Jesus do, WWJD, but what was Jesus thinking? WWJT. Here he is in the desert. He's fasting. He's praying. But what he's doing is preparing for his 3 years of ministry. And he's going to go back into a culture and society that is oppressed. He's a Jew. And before his time and during his time and continuing after his time on earth, the Jews were being oppressed by Roman authorities and even by church authorities. So he's preparing himself to re-enter into that reality, the troubled times that he needed to bring ministry to and good news to. I was taught in seminary that when there's something going on in a community or in the world, that we might consider an elephant in the living room. We need to address it. Don't let people go home and wonder, why wasn't this mentioned? So I'm going to give you four things to think about today as we begin our journey. What's going on in our world? Is there oppression? Are there people we need to reach out and touch and love, not judge? I'm not going to give you answers. I'm going to ask you questions, and we're going to think about them together. A common denominator for all of us is our love of children. And so I would bring to you a reality in today's times, unfortunately, not in the headlines all the time, though it should be. It's the thousands of children that will die today in the womb. This year, what could we do? What should we do? What will we do? A second of four things to consider involving our children. There are 35,000 children that will die today from hunger. I've been fixated on that worldwide reality for years, for at least 35 years in my life, and the number hasn't changed. This year, what can we do? What should we do? What will we do? Here's the elephant in the living room. Children are dying in schools, on street corners, in inner city neighborhoods, through no fault of their own, through nothing they've done, innocent victims. Just recently on Ash Wednesday, interestingly, in Parkland, Florida. It's happened before. It's gonna happen again. This year, what can we do? What should we do? And what will we do? My brothers and sisters, this journey that we're on this year, we have a very tangible sign to focus on. If you take your orders of worship right now and you look at the cover of them, you're going to see on them something that has been created for St. James by a well-known local graphic artist. It gives graphic representation to what Barb Schulke and Sister Joanne and I thought would be good focus for our communities this Lent. And there's three pieces of what is represented in that graphic. First of all, a journey. Christ's journey, our journey. Christ modeling what we should do, us thinking about this year what we're going to do. You'll notice in the lower left hand there are the words, journey of the heart. And you'll see what looks like a path. It is a path. If you saw the original rendering, it was actually done by hand in ashes. And from that, this graphic was created. Look at the end of the path in the upper right-hand corner. There's a sunshine. There's a light. That's Easter Sunday. That's the glory. That's what we're moving towards this year and in our lives. That's Christ's resurrection. That's our resurrection. That's what makes this all worth it. That's what made it worth it for Christ to do what he did. That's what makes it worth it for us when we go into the world and we face difficult things. So this Lent, how will we prepare, how will we journey to change our hearts this time so that this year we emerge on April 1st doing what Jesus was thinking about and doing what Jesus would do. There's another very tangible sign we have this year. If you were here Ash Wednesday, you've seen this already. I'm going to reenact it so you can fully understand the richness of it. I'm going to come join you here, okay? Is that okay with you? Thank you. Today, just a few minutes, next Sunday, all Sundays of Lent, Easter, and for the entire year. In order to take a journey, we need to be nourished. So here in the assembly, we've been nourished now by the word. We journey. We move forward. We come to receive the nourishment of the body of Christ. We ask that you continue the journey by going to one of the four pedestals, two here and two there, and reaching in and taking a Matthew 25 leap of faith card. and that you don't open it. You take it home, you pray over it, and you commit to doing what work of mercy is on the card. Now, something very interesting has happened, that since Ash Wednesday and just one Mass last night, almost all the cards are already gone. Isn't that a good sign that folks want this year to do something as a result of fasting and praying and almsgiving? So come and take those that are left. Next week, they'll be replenished. There will be other opportunities for us. So my sisters and brothers, I ask you now, are you ready to join us, join your brothers and sisters in this community to take this journey of faith this Lent?
Yes.
Let me ask again. Are you ready to take this journey of faith with us this Lent?
Yes.
Can I get an amen?
Amen.
An amen.
At this time, I would like to invite Sean and John to come forward with their sponsors, Tara and Katie. Deacon Sandy and Father Dennis and the community of St. James, these candidates, Sean Kane and John Streblo, who I present to you, are beginning their final period of preparation and purification leading to their full initiation. They have found strength in God's grace and support in our community's prayer and examples. Now they ask to be recognized for the progress they have been made in their spiritual formation, and that they receive our assurance and our blessings and our prayers as they go forth to the rite of election and continuing conversion celebrated this afternoon at St. John's Cathedral.
Community of St. James, these candidates who have been preparing for the sacraments of confirmation and Eucharist hope that they will be found ready to be chosen in Christ for the Easter sacraments. I can tell they will be found ready. It is a responsibility of this community to inquire about their readiness before they are presented to the bishop.
I ask you, sponsors, for your testimony on these candidates. Have they taken the formation in the gospel and in the Catholic way of life seriously? And have they given evidence of their own conversion by the example of their living? And I ask you, do you judge them now to be ready to be presented to the bishop for the rite of candidacy?
My dear candidates, Sean and John, this community gladly represents and recommends you to the bishop, who, in the name of Christ, will call you to the Easter sacraments. May God bring to completion the good work he has begun in you. God bless you. Thanks for doing what you're doing. Thank you. Thank you, sponsor. Well done. Thank you. God bless you.
You guys did.
Journey well.
You would give testimony to these candidates. I ask you, say, I believe in God.
We would pray for these candidates. We would pray for you. We would pray for the needs of our world.
Our Lenten response will be, help us to be the light, O Lord. We pray that this Lenten season may produce in us a more sincere effort to model our lives on the pattern of Jesus. Remembering your constant love, we pray, help us to be the light, O Lord. We pray that we may put the welfare of others above our personal ambition, ambitions for success and advancement. Remembering your constant love, we pray, help us to be light, O Lord. We pray that we accept our responsibility to see that justice is accorded the poor and the defenseless. Remembering your constant love, we pray, help us to be the light. We pray that we will continue to remember in our prayers those who suffer the anguish of mental illness. Remembering your constant love, we pray, for all catechumens in the Archdiocese and those here, our candidates, Sean and John, we pray that this faith community will support them. And we pray for them who will be participating in the rites of election and welcoming. Remembering your constant love, we pray. We remember in our prayer all those who lost their lives in South Florida, their parents, spouses, and friends who mourn them. May they be comforted in their grief with the knowledge that they are with God. Remembering your constant love, we pray. We bring to you, Lord, all those intentions listed in our Book of Intentions book. Remembering your constant love, we pray. We remember those who are signed in our Book for Life and the recently departed Jim Frederick and Elaine Sennett, who recently died. And at this Mass, we pray especially for Francis Nigbor and Jerry Wendelberger, for whom this Eucharist is offered. Remembering your constant love, we pray.
O Lord, what we begin here on your day, may we continue through these 40 days. May our prayer be ever constant, aware of our need to call out to you and that you will answer. Grant this in Christ.
Amen. Let us join together on page 19 and sing the God of Second Chance.
Come now, O Lord.
Pray with me. What you bring here, what is offered, may this be acceptable by God. Then give to us, O God, the right dispositions to make the offerings. For with them we celebrate the beginning of this sacred time. We do it in Christ who is Lord. Amen. The Lord is with you.
And your
lift your hearts. Give thanks to the Lord our God. Truly right and just, our duty and salvation, to give our thanks. You are the Almighty Eternal God. We do this through the Christ. By abstaining for 40 days from earthly food, he consecrated through fast the pattern of Lenten observance. By overturning all the snares of the ancient serpent, he taught us to cast out a leaven of malice, celebrating worthily the Paschal mystery, to pass over at last to the eternal Paschal feast. And now with your angels, we would sing. Holy and glorified are you, our God, for you love us and you are with us on the journey of life. Blessed is Jesus who's here when we gather in his name. Once for disciples and now us, the scripture is opened, the bread is broken. You are merciful to send the Holy Spirit, sanctify our bread and wine. Let these nourish and feed us on the journey to be body and blood of the risen one. At the meal, taking bread, the blessing was said, broken and handed on to disciples, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In similar way, he took the cup, once more giving thanks, this too handed on, to say to them, take this, all of you, drink from it. This is chalice of my blood, blood of new and everlasting covenant, poured out for you, for many. Our sin is forgiven. Do this in memory of me. God, what is celebrated is a memorial of the Savior, the Anointed, who led us through passion and death on a cross to resurrection. We proclaim his love until he returns. And we offer this bread of life and this chalice of blessing. Look on the offering of our church that shows forth the paschal sacrifice. Oh, by the power of the Spirit of your love, to be counted until the day of eternity, believers of Jesus, in whose body and blood we enter into communion. Partaking of the mystery, give us life in the Spirit, conformed to the image of that Christ. Confirm us in the bond of communion, that with Francis our Pope and Jerome our Bishop, with all the bishops, all those who serve the people, that our faithful look into these times with the light of their faith and devote themselves to the service of the gospel. Attentive then to the needs of all, sharing griefs and pains, joys and hopes, to faithfully bring them the good news to go forward along the way on the journey to the kingdom. We ask you to remember the intentions of this day for Francis, I believe it was Jerome or Jerry, and all who have gone before. Admit them into the light, give them fulfillment for ourselves when it's over, that we would come to the dwelling there to be with you in life, in communion with Mary, in communion with all the holy men and women down through time. We do this in Jesus. For through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in unity with the Holy Spirit, all glory and praise is yours, Almighty God, forever and ever. Peace I leave you and give to you. Look not on our faults, but our faith. Give them all, Lord, peace and unity now and forever.
Amen.
Peace be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other now a sign of Christ's peace.
Behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are you, called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
Body, blood of Jesus, bring us to your life forever. I would call up those who are making the journey with Jesus for someone else who can't be here today. May then this communion nurture those who receive and include them with us on this journey to Easter. Bless you for doing it. Amen.
Following are our announcements for this weekend. There is still time to sign up for the Lenten Catholic ID small group. Stop at the table in the lobby after Mass for details. Say yes to Jesus' personal invitation to come follow me. We need you to come to Easter planning meeting in the Great Room immediately following the 10:30 Mass today. It takes many people to create a beautiful environment. There will not be an 8 a.m. Mass in the chapel this coming Friday because of a private funeral service for Jim Frederick. Please keep the family in your prayers. As always, for more information about the activities here at St. James, check out the bulletin, website, or Facebook.
You mentioned there is a funeral Thursday at 1 p.m. in the afternoon for Peter Emmer from the parish, 59. There's another one for Jim Frederick mentioned, and I believe that's at 4 p.m. on Friday. So they've already made it to Easter. Let us pray. We are renewed with this bread. Our faith is nourished, our hope is increased, our love strengthened. That we would learn to hunger for the Lord, who is the true and living bread, and strive to live by every word that would proceed from the mouth of God. Grant us this. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord is with you. Bring blessing to others, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Following our Lenten tour guide, Jesus Christ himself, let us go now to love and serve the Lord as we go home and proceed from here in silence.